Joined now by the community co-chair of the Community and Police Action Committee, Ketsia Peters. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
What's your reaction, first of all, to the police chief's comments?
Yeah, I'm very happy and glad to hear it. We had a discussion with the deputy chief yesterday as soon as the story broke about it, and I raised my concern right away. So I'm really happy that they took the conversation that we had in the meeting seriously.
And tell me more about that conversation and what your reaction was to the story that these wristbands were being sold to members of the police service.
I mean, as a co-chair of COMPAC and a member of COMPAC, I've come to understand the difficult job that our officers have to do every day. I absolutely sympathize, and I have empathy for what they do. I mean, not every industry and profession have to wake up in the morning and kiss their family goodbye, not knowing whether or not they will be back at the end of the day. And I absolutely, sympathize with that. But what we're talking here is about, compassion for the family of the victim, in the community here. Everyone in this whole hard deal is going through a difficult time. This is a difficult time for our city, absolutely. But we have to remember that the biggest victim here is the community at this time. So we need to keep that in mind.
Do you understand the instinct to show support for the officer that's been charged in this incident? Do you understand why other members of the police service would feel a sense of solidarity with him or would want to demonstrate that?
Absolutely. Absolutely, I do. I mean, they work with each other every day. I can imagine that they've had to have each other's back in the line of duty, perhaps even save each other's life at times. I absolutely understand that sense of solidarity, that sense of connection and family with one another. I do. I'm just afraid of the perception that it would send if they're publicly supporting that officer who was actually legitimately charged with a crime. That's where the we have to be careful and crossing that line between knowing what our priorities are. Is our priority now, being solidarity with amongst ourselves and members, or is our priority is to serve and protect the public? And when they're doing their work every day and interacting with the community has to see that they're there for them.
So it is a matter of priority as far as you're concerned, that while there is a natural instinct and even on some level a commendable instinct to support each other in the workplace, that officers have to kind of put that as,
absolutely.
Well, they have to put a greater priority on serving the public and building the relationship with the public.
Exactly. That's my feeling, because since the Abdel Hamas case, the relationship between the community and the police in Ottawa has been ruptured. And what the members of the police force have to understand is that they need to work in order to earn that respect and that trust back. So I don't see how, this demonstrating this gesture publicly is going to help repair that trust and that relationship. I just don't see what good it could do.
What message do you think it sends if an officer, and I know this would be restricted only to off-duty officers, and maybe it isn't even so much about seeing somebody wearing the wristband, but more about the fact that people now know the wristbands are out there. What message do you think it sends?
I think it may send a message of being insensitive to the family and the community as well, knowing that, whether it was voluntary or not, that the action of a police officer caused the death of one of their members of their family. So I think the message would be that they're being insensitive and not giving a priority to what they took a hold for, which was to serve and protect our community. And, I've asked my community to respect the system, to respect the justice system and its process, and I feel that they should do the same. They should let everything is in the case is in the matter of the court now, and to let the process take its course.
What would your advice then be to members of the police service about this?
Absolutely, I absolutely sympathize. I know many good officers. I work with them. I speak to them. I meet with them. We've done community outreach work together, and I know there are many good officers. But in this situation, something went wrong, and we need to figure out a way how to find a solution so that it doesn't happen again. And we can only do this together with the community and the police. So we need to continue talking with each other, working with each other, and being able to understand, putting each other in each other's shoes. How would they feel? Let's say if a member of the community would have, caused the death of a police officer. and the rest of the community would have came together and say, we're going to wear a wristband to support, you know, that individual.
Right.
Right? So I think we need to be able to show compassion and understand each other's position right now.
That's a great message. Ketsia Peters, thank you very much for your time today. I appreciate it.
Thank you for calling.
Ketsia Peters, co-chair of the Community and Police Action Committee.